Hello, friends. My name is Alex Greckis, and I want to welcome you to the Finding Lost Civilization series. Now, this series is dedicated to visiting ancient sites that time has long forgotten. Today is a cool, blustery, windy day, and so I've got my hat on, my winter clothes, and my glasses. But anyways, I'm in a place called the Inyo Mountains in California, visiting an ancient site called Blackrock Well. Now, you ask yourself, why did ancient man come here to this vast, desolate area? Well, that remains a mystery, but we have to remember that thousands of years ago, this area, which is a desert-like area right now, used to be lush and verdant and supported life. Well, anyways, at Blackrock Well, we're going to find the symbols left behind by ancient man, and I invite you to come trek with me. I know we're going to have a fun time today. Well, friends, we're in a wash right over here. And of course, thousands of years ago, this probably was a flowing river or stream. Right over there is a site we're going to, okay? It's called Blackrock. But look at this right over here, this boulder. It looks innocuous, not much to it. But when you look at it, this is an ancient petroglyph. This is very, very old. Let me show you something over here. As you come up on a boulder, you can see these lines, crisscross lines that have been etched into the boulder. And right over here, although there's almost nothing left, you can see some kind of pattern. Maybe there was a spiral there. But look at this right over here. You can see this has been grooved out, this has been grooved out, and then over here there's lines coming down. But look at this. This is what's really fantastic. Right here on the top lip of the rock, you can see a groove line right over here. And right over here, look at this. These are called cupules. Right here, these are cupules. And so these are ancient symbols. Meaning has been lost in time, though. And look at this, right over here, it comes across right up here to the central point, and there's another cupule right over here. So this line and these cupules continue down along the boulder. I tell you, this is really fascinating. Friends, as I'm looking for signs of ancient life, I came across this here laying on the old stream bed. Take a look at this right over here. Okay, here we go. Can you see that? This is part of an arrowhead, a point. Look at this. I tell you, this is beautiful. So this definitely verifies that the ancients lived in this area. Well, as I was walking along the wash, I noticed this petroglyph here. Very interesting. Look at this here, a series of abraded dots, or pecked dots right over here. And then there's, I don't know if this is a figure, it looks like a cross, but the interesting petroglyphs are right over here. The petroglyphs here are rare in a sense that I don't see them that often. And this petroglyph that we're going to come up to right over here, uses what's called the scratch technique, okay? So if you look real close, it's a scratch in here, as opposed to a pecking or an abrasion, okay? So this is one linear line. And look at this right over here. If you look real close, you can see the fine scratch marks right here and right there. Well, friends, we're at the Blackrock Well site, and look at this boulder over here. Now, first of all, there's petroglyphs everywhere, and you ask yourself, was this a village site or an initiation site or a worship site? My feeling is that this is probably some sort of worship site. Let me show you something very special here in this boulder. You can see that there's some symbols, but you know they're very difficult to discern, except one which is very, very beautiful. Let me show you this over here. This symbol right here in front of us is a Yoni symbol. What they've taken is this rock right over here, and they've taken a natural element of the rock, which is perhaps this area right here, and look at this. They went ahead and abraded this whole area right here. Right here, and actually, if I'm looking here, it seems to be cut, incised right in here. This is known as a Yoni symbol. You'll find these at fertility sites. This represents the vulva right here. I'll tell you, this is really amazing. As I was examining this petroglyph symbol right over here, I looked down to the ground and I noticed this over here. Let me show you, okay? Look at this right over here. This is a flake of obsidian. And so you know the natives were here working with obsidian, probably to make points for their arrows for hunting. So this definitely was an area where ancient man came to visit. As I said, this appears to me to be some sort of initiation or worship site.
Thank you.
Well, friends, as I was climbing amongst these boulders, I noticed that there are several different styles present here. One style is known as the Great Basin Archaic Style or the Southwestern Archaic Style. These petroglyphs are best described as containing circulars, dots, wavy line, and rectangular features that don't seem to represent anything that we can identify today. Oftentimes, people refer to this type of petroglyph style as being somewhat abstract in nature. Another style that I identified here, I'll just generally say, is figurative in nature. In other words, you can identify what is being drawn on these boulders. We can see plenty of bighorn sheep, and perhaps this area was plentiful in game, and this spot was chosen to honor the game taken. And so when we see that different cultures had placed their symbols on these boulders hundreds, if not thousands, of years ago, we ask ourselves, who were these people? Well, we know that about 1,000 years ago, a Western Shoshone tribe known as the Timpisha people moved into this area. And so we can assume that at least some of these petroglyphs that we are observing were left here by the Timpisha people. However, as to any idea who the people that preceded them were and how old some of these symbols are, except to say that they may be thousands of years old, has been lost in time.